Hello everyone. Now triangles exercise 5.3 question number 1. In triangle ABC and triangle DBC, the two triangles are ABC and DBC. The two isosceles, they both are the isosceles triangles. Isosceles matlab two sides equal hain. So AB AC ke equal hain aur ye wala jo triangle hai isme OB सॉरी इट इज डी बी सी के इक्वल है. नाउ ऑन द सेम साइड बी सी एंड द वर्टाइसेस ए एंड डी आर ड्रॉन ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ बी सी. इफ ए डी इज एक्सटेंडेड टू इंटरसेक्ट बी सी एट पी, ए डी इज एक्सटेंडेड टू इंटरसेक्ट एट द पॉइंट पी, शो दैट द ट्रायंगल ए बी डी. फर्स्ट थिंग we have to check the triangles. In the figure we will see where the triangle ABD and ACD is. Okay, this figure is already given in the question. So ABD means ye wala triangle, ye ek triangle hai aapka, aur dusra wala triangle ACD. Again ACD is nothing but this one triangle. These two triangles we have to consider and we have to prove that these two triangles are congruent. It's very easy to prove the congruency. Why? Because already the two sides of the triangles are equal. This AB is equals to AC and DB is equals to DC and they are having one common side. Dono triangle ka ek common side hai, which is nothing but AD. So by SSS congruence rule both the triangles will be congruent. So let's start with the stepwise solution here. In the solution, first one we are taking here. In triangle ABD and triangle ACD, जो दो triangles आपको given है, अभी उसमें क्या होगा? AD is equals to AD. Why? Because it is the common side. Common side मतलब दोनों triangles में भी वो use हो रहा है. Then AB is equals to AC. This is also given. Question में आपको दिया है कि वो isosceles triangle है, मतलब दोनों sides equal हैं. Then DB is equals to DC. ये आपका जो triangle DBC है, वो भी एक isosceles triangle है, तो दोनों sides equal हैं. Therefore, the triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD by SSS congruence rule. All the three sides are equal to the another three sides of the triangle. That's why the triangles are congruent. This is your first solution. Now the second solution. What the second solution is? Triangle ABP. So what the two triangles we are considering, we will name them first. In the second, in triangle ABP and triangle ACP. Which two triangles we are considering here? This side. ये वाला आपका पूरा triangle and this side one more triangle ACP we are considering. So now in this triangle two sides are already equal, which is AB and AC. So we can write AB is equals to AC as it is given. And then this angle will be equal. Why these two angles will be equal? Because they are nothing but the CPCT of the first triangle. So angle BAP will be equals to PAC. Why? Because it's nothing but the CPCT of first one. अभी जो आपने first दो triangles congruent proof किए, उसके वो angles हैं, तो दोनों angles equal हैं. And common side is AP. AP is equals to AP, which is the common side. Now we are having one side angle and then one side, so it is forming the side angle side congruence rule. Therefore the triangle ABP is congruent to the triangle ACP by SSS congruence rule. These are the two solutions for this question. Now the third solution is, what the third question is, AP bisects angle A as well as angle D. So what the angle A is here, it is bisecting to both angles. Bisecting means dividing into two equal parts. So what you have to prove? AP. Already these two are equal, we are saying, means it has already proved that angle AP is bisecting to angle A. Then we have to solve it for angle D. So let us see here the third solution. What the third solution is, what we have to prove. First we will write that to prove AP bisects angle A as well as angle D. And this is your given figure. A, B, C is an isosceles triangle. This is your point P and this is your point D. And what we have to prove? These two angles are equal. We have to prove in this third bit. So firstly, as these two triangles are congruent, the angle A, we can say it is bisecting. So what we can write? Angle BAP is equals to angle PAC, which is nothing but the CPCT of first one. So what we can say? These two are equal means angle AP bisects angle A. जो AP line है वो angle A को दो equal parts में divide कर रहा है. Now same way we have to solve it for angle D. How we can prove for this? If you'll see here carefully, they are forming a linear pair of angles. One side, if you are saying ADB plus BDP is equals to 180 degrees. Nothing but linear pair of angles. Now secondly, this side ADC plus CDP is equals to 180. This is also nothing but a linear pair of angles. If we will compare here both the equations, as they both are equating to 180 and 180, RHS are also equal. From 1 and 2, we can write angle ADB plus BDP is equals to ADC plus CDP. Now further, what you are having, ADB and this ADC, they both are equal. How they will be equal? Because they are nothing but the CPCT of the first one. जो आपने first में congruency proof की थी, वो है, that are the triangles. Angle ADB will be equals to angle ADC. Why? Because they are nothing but the CPCT of first one. जब दोनों angles equal हैं, then they can get cancelled. So what will remain? BDP will be equals to CDP. Now again, if you'll see carefully, these two angles are equal. When the angles are equal means the line AP is bisecting to the angle D. Therefore, we can write AP bisects angle D, which is your required solution. AP we have to find for it bisecting for A as well as it's bisecting for angle D. This is your third solution. Now the last one solution of that bit, first bit, what did you have to prove in that? AP is the fourth one. AP is the perpendicular bisector of BC. AP is the perpendicular bisector of BC. As the word perpendicular bisector, perpendicular means it should be 90 as well as it should be dividing into two equal parts. If we'll see the figure again, a triangle with the name ABC, a line AP, and one more triangle here A, D, B, D and C. And we have to prove these two are equal and this angle is 90 degree. These two things we have to prove. For the first one, bisector, what we can say, APB will be equal, BP will be equals to PC. How? They are nothing but the CPCT of second. Second, already we had proved that these two triangles, APB and this side triangle APC, they both are congruent. When the triangles are congruent, their corresponding parts must be equal. That's why we can say BP is equals to PC. अभी आपको जो प्रूफ करना है परपेंडिकुलर, परपेंडिकुलर मतलब 90 डिग्री. वन मोर थिंग, व्हाट वी कैन राइट, ए पी बी प्लस ए पी सी इज इक्वल्स टू 180. व्हाई? बिकॉज दे आर ऑन द सेम लाइन, दे आर नथिंग बट द लीनियर पेयर ऑफ एंगल्स. एंड अगेन ए पी बी एंड ए पी सी आर नथिंग बट दे बोथ आर इक्वल एंगल्स. व्हाई दे विल बी इक्वल? अगेन इट्स नथिंग बट द सी पी सी टी ऑफ सेकेंड. इन सी पी सी टी मतलब दोनों ये एंगल्स भी इक्वल होंगे क्योंकि ट्राइंगल्स कॉन्ग्रुएंट है. सो वॉट वी कैन राइट, नेम दिस एज इक्वल्स टू एक्स, बोथ द एंगल्स इक्वल टू एक्स. सो वॉट द इक्वेशन, वन विल बिकम एक्स प्लस एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू 180, देन टू एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू 180, एक्स विल बी इक्वल्स टू 180. दिस टू वेन वी आर शिफ्टिंग इट कम्स टू डिविजन, 180 बाय 2 इज 90. So what the x we have considered here, these two angles. Therefore, the angle APB is equals to angle APC is equals to 90 degree. So what it means, आपका angle भी 90 है और equal parts में भी divide हो रहा, मतलब वो perpendicular bisector है. This implies AP is the perpendicular bisector of BC. Hope you have understood this question. If you are having any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Thank you.